Hello everyone, the topic of our discussion is the organic farming. Now we are very well known about the harmful effects of the excessive use of fertilizers, the chemical fertilizers, the weedicides, the pesticides, the insecticides. Now keeping in mind of these harmful effects of the excessive use of fertilizers, our farmers have now shifted to organic farming. Organic farming was started in 1930 by Sir Albert. Now this organic farming is the formation of crops, the use of the production of crops by minimum or no use of chemical fertilizers. It includes the excessive use of biofertilizers. Now this biofertilizers can be green algae. Then we can have the use of farmyard manure, organic fertilizers. Now organic fertilizers or the manure or this farmyard manure can be the vermicomposting also. It can be the use of biofertilizers as the green algae is there because it increases the soil fertility. Then we can have different cropping patterns. The different methods of cropping patterns is we can have mixed cropping, we can have intercropping also, and we can have crop rotation because all these are responsible to protect the crops from weeds. And they again help to increase the soil fertility. And then we can have the mechanical and the manual weeding methods that we are removing the weeds from the crops. And then we can have extensive use of biopesticides. Biopesticides is the neem extract, the extract of neem plant, because that is repelling, that is used as an insect repellent from the leaves of the plants. If we spray that, and that is removing the pest or insects from the plants. Now this organic fertilizers, or the manure which is formed, this manure is the decomposed organic manure. Now this decomposed organic matter is what? It is formed by the decomposition of the organic and the plant and the animal waste with the help of microorganisms in the soil. Now this manure which is formed, this is very helpful for the by the farmers. By very first, it is increasing the soil fertility. How? Because it is helping to add humus in the soil. When it is adding the humus in the soil, the common of the biofertilizer is the cow dung, the manure which is used. Because cow dung is which is formed by the bacterial decomposition of animal waste, that is increasing soil fertility. It is adding humus to the soil. It is helping to increase the water retention capacity of the soil. It is making the soil porous, and it is increasing the formation of roots in the soil, and the roots can hold the soil particles together, so that prevents soil erosion also. So the types of manures which are used, very first we can have the farmyard manure. This farmyard manure is formed by the decomposition of the farm waste. This farm waste, we can have the chemical dung, we can have the straw, the paddy waste. And then we can have the green manure. Green manure, we can have the growing of the green plants in the field, and that is burrowed in the soil, and it helps increase the nitrogen content of soil. Then we can have compost. This compost is formed by the organic waste, that is the vegetable waste and the fruit waste, the peel, the kitchen waste, that is dumped in the soil, and that is with the help of soil bacteria, it increases the fertility of soil. And last of all, we have the vermicomposting. Vermicomposting is the rearing of earthworms in the soil, because earthworm is feeding on decaying leaves, and the excreta of the earthworm, that is very rich in nitrogen content. So this excreta of earthworm, the casting of earthworm, is used as increasing the soil fertility. Then we can talk about now the increased production of food grains with the help of high yielding varieties of the plants. That is resulting in green revolution. So this green revolution is called as the golden era of Indian agriculture, and this was introduced by Dr. Norman in Mexico, because he introduced the varieties of wheat by hybridization. And this in India was introduced by Dr. Swaminathan, and he introduced the maximum variety of wheat in India, that is high yielding varieties by crossbreeding. So this was the disease resistant varieties which were introduced. We have for rice, we have for wheat, we have for food grains, we have for cereals, and what is the hybrid varieties? Hybrid varieties is the best qualities of the two plants are taken and they are resulting in the production of maximum of food grains, disease resistant varieties, helping to increase the soil fertility, and then they are drought resistant varieties also. They are resulting in they grow for in a shorter period of time, and then they are giving us maximum production. Now this, the aim of green revolution is for it should increase the, or it should help to improve the economic condition of the Indian farmers also, so that with the lesser input they can have the maximum output and they can help to increase the economic condition of our country as well as of themselves. So this hybrid, the use of hybrid varieties, this is very important for maximum production and better resistance of this. Thank you so much.